In previous videos, we've learned about the Thevenin equivalent source and the Thevenin equivalent resistance. In this video, I'd like to introduce the Norton equivalent source and the Norton equivalent resistance. To introduce this, let's first review what a Thevenin source and resistance are. Thevenin's theorem says that we can take any combination of linear circuit elements and represent them with just a single Thevenin equivalent source and a single Thevenin equivalent resistor. It means that while a circuit, in reality, might be very complicated, we can at least represent it from the outside, from two terminals looking in, by a very simple equivalent circuit. You might recall that in order to find the Thevenin equivalent voltage, we merely have to measure the voltage at the two terminals without anything attached to it. To find the Thevenin equivalent resistance, we merely need to find the equivalent resistance looking back by zeroing out all of the sources. Norton's theorem says something very similar. It says that any combination of linear circuit elements can be represented by a Norton equivalent current source and a Norton equivalent resistance. It's the current version of a Thevenin equivalent source and resistance. The procedure for finding the Thevenin equivalent voltage was simply to measure the voltage at the two terminals. If we want to represent a circuit by its Norton equivalent current source, we merely need to measure the current that would flow out through the terminals if they were short-circuited. You can see that in this particular circuit, if we just measure I, it's going to be In. Let's find the Norton equivalent current of our Thevenin equivalent circuit. If we measure the current coming out of this circuit, it's just going to be V/Th divided by R/Th. Likewise, let's find our Thevenin equivalent voltage of our Norton equivalent circuit. Without any current coming out of these two terminals while measuring the Thevenin equivalent voltage, we know that V is just I times R. That's our Thevenin equivalent voltage. You can see that these two equations are the same. Therefore, it's possible to transform a Thevenin equivalent source into a Norton equivalent source. Let's now find the Thevenin and Norton equivalent resistances of these two circuits. You might recall that the procedure for finding the Thevenin equivalent resistance was to zero out all of the sources inside the circuit and then just measure the resistance looking in from the two terminals. Since this is already a Thevenin equivalent circuit, such a measurement of the resistance would just yield the Thevenin equivalent resistance. It turns out that the procedure for finding the Norton equivalent resistance is the same as that for finding the Thevenin equivalent resistance. We merely need to measure the resistance between the two terminals while zeroing out any sources in the circuit. If we zero out our current source in the Norton circuit and measure the resistance, it's just going to be R/N, the Norton equivalent resistance. Let's now find the Norton equivalent resistance of our Thevenin equivalent circuit. The procedure is the same, so it's clear that our measured resistance, or our Norton equivalent resistance, would just be equal to the Thevenin equivalent resistance. If we applied the procedure for finding our Thevenin equivalent resistance to our Norton equivalent circuit, then we wind up measuring our Thevenin equivalent resistance and find that it's just equal to our Norton equivalent resistance. What I've shown is that the Thevenin source and resistance can be very easily transformed into a Norton equivalent source and resistance, and vice versa. These two are just analogs of one another. The only important difference between these two representations of a simple circuit is whether you want to have a high impedance or a low impedance at the source and at the load. We'll look at that in a future video. If you enjoyed watching this video, then you might be interested in following our playlist and learning more about the fundamentals of electrical circuits.